The book of Hebrews, chapter 13. Hebrews, chapter 13, verses 5 through 9a. Hebrews, chapter 13, verses 5 through 9a. However you want to read it, please feel free. And for those of you who just want to meditate as I read, the word reads as follows. Make sure that your character is free from the love of money. Be content with what you have. For he himself has said, I will never desert you, nor will I ever forsake you. So that we confidently say, the Lord is my helper. I will not be afraid. What will man do to me? Remember those who led you, who spoke the word of God to you, and considering the result of their conduct, imitate their faith. Jesus Christ is the same yesterday and today and forever. Do not be carried away by varied and strange teachings. We're going to focus our meditation today on verse 5 and verse 8. The King James Version in verse 5 says, I will never leave you nor forsake you. Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today, and forever. I'd like to just invite you to meditate with me on the topic, God's got you. God's got you, regardless of time. You know, I love this expression, I got you. It's been made famous by the youngest member of our family who's always saying, I got you. It means calm down. I got you. Don't worry about it. I got you. Stop fussing. I got you. It's under control. I got you. I've actually already done it, Mama. I got you. So when the kids say, I got you, that's a good thing. So just imagine God saying, I got you. How much more powerful is it when God says, I got you? And I dare say that that is what we are being reminded in the book of Hebrews in these passages. You know, when you think about the book of Hebrews, it's an interesting book because its name, Hebrews, it is named for the people to whom it was written. At a time when they were feeling a little persecuted against. You see, it's fascinating because when you think about the Hebrews, you think about this grand tradition of Judaism. You think about how built into the culture, into the lifestyles, into the very fabric of their existence. But they had made something. The transition to accept Jesus Christ as the Messiah that the Torah anticipated. But at this time, some of the Christians are feeling just a little weary, just a little put upon, just a little tired, just a little sad, just a little out of sorts. And dare I say, doesn't that remind you of how we're feeling right about now? You know, when you think about it, we need encouragement. There's so much confusion and calamity in the world. Everything just seems to be torn up in one way or another. Things just seem to be towed out from the flow of. And that means literally, because if I could just get some rest. Oh, it's difficult even just to be with ourselves.
Yeah.
Huh? We sit there and we think and we reflect and we stress. And then it gets even worse. It stretches into parents not speaking to children and children killing parents we read about and people focusing on themselves, not caring about what happens around them. Being polite is frowned upon. Just driving down the street obeying the law is not something that people like. They'll blow your horn at you. Because you drove with the light. And light is red. Where am I supposed to go? And it just makes you wonder what people are thinking. Some folks are so angry, they can't even tell you why they're angry. So
any variety of
other individuals who, to whom this book has been attributed, there is a message here for us. And that message is as relevant today as it was then. One of the words that was used is the word never. The interesting thing about the word never is that in English, never means not at any time. But the Greek translation uses a word that means the absence of being with you always. The word never doesn't actually exist except in relation to being with you always. I found that utterly fascinating because the message is not that I will not be with you, that I will never not be with you. It is the message that I will always be with you. I will never leave you, but I will never leave you because I am always with you, therefore incapable of ever being separated and apart from you. Huh. I thought that was interesting. But then I went on. The word yesterday. Yesterday means the day before today. But it also means at a time not long in the past. College was at a time for me not long in the past. High school graduation was at a time not long in the past. That concert was at a time not long in the past. Admissions to school was at a time not long ago in the past. The memories that we have in our minds, in our hearts, in our spirits are from not long in the past. Yesterday. Today. Today. Okay, Stephanie, that's obvious. Really? Seriously? You're going to define the word today? Yes. Because today means on, during, or for this day. But today also means this present time. Where we are right now. Our existence right now. Our feelings right now. Our experiences right now. Everything that's going on in your mind right now. Everything you may be feeling in your body right now. Everything you may have reflected on your way here is right now. Today. Today. Forever. Forever is a powerful word. I love the word forever. I began to learn the word forever in the context of love. I will love you forever. Forever? And then the song goes, forever, ever? What's forever, ever? Well, let's look at that for a little bit. Forever is for an endless time. Forever is an endless time. But then, Merriam-Webster said, let's take that one step further. Forever is for all time, at all times. Now, I don't know about you, but when you add up never, which means always with you, because never has never existed. When you think about yesterday, yesterday as the day before and a time not long past, today as present and forever as all time, I think that adds up to always, always, always and forever. Forever, ever, and probably even forever, ever, 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 which is something that only God can provide. So my message today to you is simple. Be of good courage. God's got you no matter what time. Be of good courage because God has got you no matter what's going on. Be of good courage. You already have a cause. Oh, I'm not surprised that ISIS, ISO, whatever, is gaining new converts. We are walking around wondering what is important. We are walking around wanting to connect to something. We're walking around in pain, wanting to be a part of a community. Well, I submit to you today that Jesus Christ died that we might have life in that more abundantly. I submit to you today that we are here to live forth that life. I submit to you today that whatever you may be dealing with, God is still on the throne. And I submit to you today, as Brother Chambers said in his devotional, do not preoccupy yourself with the busyness of the things that you're engaged in. Do not preoccupy yourself with the things that seem to be taking up most of your time, but avoid has said, I have died that you might have life, and that more abundantly. Take my yoke upon you and learn of me, for I am meek and lowly in heart, and ye shall find rest unto your souls. Rest unto your souls. Peace in your mind. Peace in your body. Healing in your family. Healing in your spirit. Healing in your communities. Healing in this very world. Oh, this world that seems so confusing. So God's got you when you feel sad. God's got you when you're in pain. God's got you when you don't know what's going to happen next. God's got you when you feel like you don't have control of your own body. God's got you when you don't know what to do. God has got you when you're angry. God's got you when you're confused. God's got you when they did you wrong. God's got you when somebody's sick. God's got you when you're sick. God's got you no matter what's going on. God's got you, and it's irrelevant what space. It's irrelevant what time. Because when you add up never, today, forever, tomorrow, you get always that God is on your side. I don't know about you, but that's a heck of an assurance that if you got somebody that loves you so much, then no matter what you do, God's got you. Oh, God said to you, I got you, Jonah. I got you, Dana. I got you. I got you. I got you, Gene. I got you, Luke. I got you. No matter what it is,
yes,
that you are facing,
yes,
he said to you today, because God's got it. And I tell you, in that very confusing time of my life, I can't even tell you what the problem was. I can just tell you I was troubled. But I can tell you this, that as I look back over my life and I think things over, oh, I can truly say that I've been blessed and be reminded that a saint